Greetings to the students of class 5. Welcome to your online maths class. Dear students, we are doing chapter number 7, geometry. In today's class, we shall learn about angles and the various types of angles. So let us begin. Dear students, we have already learnt about reading the clock. Today, we shall learn something different with the help of clock hands. Here, we can see different angles made by clock hands. Dear students, a running clock makes various angles. An angle is formed where the two clock hands meet at a common point. When we look around, we can notice angles formed by various objects like these. So students, rotation of a ray along a point is known as angle. Standard measurement of an angle is degree. Tiny zero on top right of a number represents degree. And there are seven types of angles based on degree, such as zero angle, acute angle, right angle, obtuse angle, straight angle, reflex angle, and complete angle. In this chapter, we will study only three types of angles, and the most important of them is right angle. An angle which has measurement of 90 degree is called right angle, and it resembles English alphabet L. Dear students, square and rectangular shapes are formed using right angles. For example, the pencil box and the book form right angles. And when we rotate the book, there is no change in the measurement of an angle. That is, it remains a right angle. The angle that is smaller than a right angle is called an acute angle. An acute angle measures less than 90 degree. It means all the angles that are bigger than 0 degree and smaller than 90 degree are known as acute angles. When you sharpen your pencil, an acute angle is formed on its tip. The angle that is bigger than a right angle is called an obtuse angle. An obtuse angle measures more than 90 degree. It means all the angles that are bigger than 90 degree and smaller than 180 degree are known as obtuse angles. Pentagon, octagon, and such type of triangles are examples of obtuse angle. A wide open hand fan forms an obtuse angle. Now, let us identify various angles from a running clock. Which type of angle is formed here? Look, students, when we place our thumb and index finger in this position, a right angle is formed. So this way, we can have estimate of right angle. Now students, this angle is anterior to right angle, which means it is smaller than 90 degree. Therefore, it is an acute angle. Now students, can you identify this angle? It is also anterior to the right angle, that is less than 90 degree. Therefore, it is also an acute angle. Now, let us move forward, and here it is very clear from the image that a right angle is formed between the clock hands. Now, as the clock hands have changed their position, can you identify the type of angle? Look, students, here also the angle between the clock hands measures 90 degree. Therefore, this one is also right angle. And in this position also, angle between the clock hands is right angle. Now students, we'll see what type of angle is formed here. See, this angle is exterior to the right angle, which means it is bigger than 90 degree. Therefore, it is an obtuse angle. And in this position also, the angle formed by the clock hands is exterior to the right angle. That is bigger than 90 degree. So it is an obtuse angle. Dear students, In first question of exercise 7.1, we have to identify the type of angles. Let us solve its part A. We will identify the angles using our hand in 90 degree position. Look students, the given angle is interior to the right angle, which means it is smaller than 90 degree. So it is an acute angle. Now, let us solve its part B. Here, the given angle is exterior to the right angle, which means it is bigger than 90 degree. So it is an obtuse angle. So students, we have seen that identifying the type of angle is really easy and fun. For your homework, you will solve all the parts of question 1 from exercise 7.1. Thank you so much.